Hello friends, here we see a beautiful house, right? Let's see the ceiling of this house. We see the wooden pillars here, right? But remember, when you put these kind of wooden pillars on top for the decoration, you have to pay the polishing charges based on amount of wood which is polished. As you can see, these wooden pillars looks like different kinds of cuboids. Right? So if we know the surface area of this cuboid, we will be able to find out how much is the total area, and then based on per square meter of the polishing rate, we can pay that. But suppose if you just remember the surface area of the cuboid as a formula, and you just remember that, will it be solve the problem? Not really. Remember, you have to really see which surface is visible here. How much should you pay the polishing charges? A typical cuboid has 6 faces. But as you can see, in this particular example on the ceiling here, we have how many faces? 1 face, 2 face which is at the bottom, and the 3rd face which is on the other side. So there are only 3 visible faces of each of these cuboid. So you should be really knowing how to derive the surface area of a cube versus just remembering the formula of it. Because if you just remember the formula, you might calculate it completely wrong. Actually, the value will be way higher than what you have to pay. So surface area as a concept is how much portion is visible of a given solid shape. You calculate that area, and that is what is the surface area. So in this example, this cuboid has 3 visible faces, and the total surface area of the cuboid in this example, where only 3 faces are visible, will be different compared to a cuboid which has all the 6 faces visible. So we are going to learn how to compute surface area. And I hope you understood the value of it, because without knowing how to derive the formula, you might really calculate the surface area differently, because it is actually different based on how many faces are visible. So let's see that in our next video. Till then, bye-bye.